the Biden administration takes a hard line on trade with China, the U.S. will maintain its combative approach, which was adopted during the Trump administration. U.S. Trade Representative Catherine Tai says, while Washington will seek new trade talks, existing tariffs on Chinese goods will stay. She adds, China will be held accountable for the commitments it agreed to in the first phase of their trade deal.
I think that we are going to have and have to have really honest conversations with China about all of the elements of the Phase One agreement. These are commitments that China made.
But above all else, we must defend to the hilt our economic interests. And that means taking all steps necessary to protect ourselves against the waves of damage inflicted over the years through unfair competition. We need to be prepared to deploy all tools and explore the development of new ones, including through collaboration with other economies and countries.
Tracking experts say China is on pace to fall short of its purchasing commitments of buying an additional $200 billion worth of American goods and services by 2021 under its Phase One trade deal with the U.S. An extensive leak of financial documents exposes the alleged wealth held by public officials worldwide in offshore accounts. Here's a look into the contents of the so-called Pandora Papers.
A massive leak of financial documents published on Sunday allegedly ties world leaders to secret stores of wealth, from the King of Jordan to associates of Russian President Vladimir Putin. It's being called the Pandora Papers and was published by several major news organizations. The dump of almost 12 million records comes 5 years after the leak known as the Panama Papers, which exposed how money was hidden by the wealthy in ways undetectable by law enforcement agencies. The International Consortium of Investigative Journalists said the new trove of files were linked to dozens of current and former national leaders and amount to the biggest leak of offshore data in history. However, the group did not say how the files were obtained, and Reuters could not independently verify the allegations or documents. Among the claims are that Jordan's King Abdullah, a close ally of the United States, used offshore accounts to spend more than $100 million on luxury homes in the U.S. and U.K. Lawyers representing Abdullah told the consortium he had not, quote, made any use whatsoever of the proceeds of aid or assistance intended for public use. The Washington Post, which is part of the network, reported on the case of Svetlana Krivonogik, a Russian woman who the paper says was in a secret relationship with President Vladimir Putin. The Post says that just weeks after she gave birth to a baby girl in 2003, she became the owner of a Monaco apartment through an offshore company. The Kremlin did not respond to requests for comment. The documents also allege that the Czech Republic's Prime Minister, Andrej Babiš, owned an offshore estate worth $22 million on the French Riviera. The news comes just days before the country's parliamentary elections. Babiš on Sunday denied any wrongdoing while speaking during a televised debate.
Facebook's platforms, including Instagram and WhatsApp, now online after a global outage. The platforms went down around midnight Manila time. They came back online just before 7 this morning. According to Facebook's chief technology officer, they experienced networking issues. Founder and CEO Mark Zuckerberg apologized for the disruption. With nowhere to go to air their thoughts, the disruption prompted people to flood Twitter. The microblogging site took advantage of the situation and poked fun at the global outage, tweeting, "Hello, literally everyone."